A warm welcome to each one of you for joining today's webinar from Toradex. In today's session, we'll be covering two main topics. First one, we'll see how to get started when you are working on Toradex system on modules, also called SOMs. And in the second phase, we will learn about Torizon, which is an easy to use industrial Linux platform developed by Toradex. My name is Vishwas and I manage sales and business development for Toradex in India. And the second speaker for today's session will be Ritesh, who is from our technical team. Few key points to be noticed for today's session. We request you to type your questions in the chat window of GoToWebinar. We will take all the questions in the last phase of today's session. And we also request for your feedback and inputs that you can mention in the survey related to this webinar. Please reach out to us with your requirements or feature wish list by writing to us at india@toradex.com or support@toradex.com. A recording of today's webinar will be available within a week's time. We also encourage you to attend the archived webinars at toradex.com/webinars. Also request you to subscribe to Toradex channel on YouTube for video tutorials as well as demos. Let me first share with you a few things about Toradex. Toradex provides ARM-based system on modules, which are primarily based on Cortex-A processors from NXP Semiconductors and NVIDIA. From Toradex, we provide reliable and easy-to-use embedded solutions that enable our customers to reach out to market fast and also in lowering the cost of ownership. Toradex provides these modules with long-term availability of minimum 10 years. Other thing is that Toradex provides these modules under two main product families. And within each product family, there are different modules. Now, advantage offered by Toradex today is all these modules within a specific product family, they are pin compatible, which means they offer scalability where customers can start upscale or downscale these modules for a particular application. Other advantage to our Indian customers is that they can buy locally because we stock the material in our warehouse in India. Toradex provides production ready software today, and these are available in two OS versions, which is WinC and Linux, and both these are supported directly from Toradex. If the customers who need another OS, which is Android, that is made available through our ecosystem partners. In this way, customers' design cycle time is reduced when they buy these SOMs because they get the production ready quality software and they can focus on developing their application. Other thing is that we maintain our ecosystem partners who support customers right from customizing the base ports if the customer requires customization. Otherwise, Toradex also offers these base ports which are available off the shelf. Toradex headquartered in Switzerland was set up in year 2003. Today, we have an active base of about 3,000 plus customers who are well supported by 135 employees operating out of 8 global offices. India market has a special focus. That's why you will see there are 3 regional offices supporting customers in India. As Toradex, we are a strong believer in our ecosystem partners. Today, we have about 50 plus proven partners, some of them which are in India as well as outside. We are proud to share that more than 1 million modules have already been deployed in various applications. And some of the top markets are like industrial automation, medical or healthcare, test and measurement, transportation, which includes automotive applications also. And then of course, smart city, which includes home and city automation. The typical volumes of Toradex customers vary from as low as about 100 units to about 50,000 units annually. Toradex customers select our modules because of quality and high reliability. Some of the applications will require industrial grade temperature. So in that way, Toradex also have an option of supplying modules, which are industrial grade, which is basically minus 40 to plus 85 degrees centigrade. All the Toradex modules are validated for shock and vibration resistance. and this is tested by an accredited Swiss test lab, and all the results are available on Toradex website. Toradex modules are also manufactured in production sites which are ISO 9001 certified, and all the modules go through full functional testing, whereby a unique serial number is mentioned for each module, and that offers a better traceability. Toradex modules carry a warranty of about 2 years, and we also offer the assurance that these modules will be available for a minimum lifetime availability of 10 years. So at this point, we would like to run a small poll to understand the different OS being used by our customers. This poll will be available for a few more seconds. Yeah, we will have the results shortly. So we see that maximum attendees in today's session, they are using Linux. Of course, there is a mix of WinC and Android also. So thanks for your feedback. We would actively look forward to support you in your designs. At this point, I would like to bring in Ritesh for the technical part of the presentation.
Hello, thank you, Vishwas, for your kind introduction. And thank you to all our audience for taking your time to join this webinar. So we are really excited to bring you this first India-specific webinar, and we thought to begin with getting started. And we hope you find this session useful. I work as a team lead at Toradex Systems India Private Limited. And then let me begin with just telling you the overview for the remaining session. Our agenda for today, we will be providing you overview of modules, basically computer module. We will give you overview about Apalis and the Colibri family, Toradex portfolio. And we will introduce our Torizon, that's our new offering for our Linux platform. And then there will be some basic information, and we will understand, of course, the development flow for the Torizon and the application development, where we will understand more about containers and how containers are useful when you are doing application development for this Torizon as a platform. Of course, we will be writing Hello World with Torizon. Then after that, we have a Toradex installer. This is a flashing tool from Toradex. And last, we will take up all your questions and we will answer one by one. So our first slide is about basic of computer module. We will be saying, we will understand how we are solving and addressing the problems of today embedded product, complex embedded product, how they are useful in designing and developing, and how right from the evaluation stage to the production stage, we are there to help you. So if we talk about COM, so they are basically highly complex and multi-layer board. So we have a processor on them. We have a flash memory for storing the operating system. We have RAM for running our process and operating system processes. Then we have power management embedded on the module. So this power management is responsible for generating low voltages. These low voltages are needed for various interfaces which are present on the module. Then we provide you operating system. There are flavors of operating system. There are different version and distribution like embedded Linux, Angstrom. Then we are coming with Torizon. Then we do all the board support packages. We provide all the low level drivers, all the software stacks which you may need for your application development. We provide the library framework for all those interfaces. So these all parts are what we are doing at our own on this system on module or computer on module. So when we connect this particular module to any of the carrier board available, so we have all the physical interface now ready. So we can use this physical interface for our application development. So together, these two system forms a complete embedded computer. And depending upon your application, you can utilize it any of the field, which we already discussed in Vishwas' presentation, that you can use it for transportation, you can use in medical, you can use in aerospace, or any application which you can think of. So in simple, the purpose of this module and the purpose of making this two separate system is to simplify your application development. Because all the complex part is been taken care on the module side. be it a high speed RAM interfacing, be it a complex low level driver, everything has been taken care by Toradex. So you are left with your own application development or your application logic for the from the hardware side of. So similarly, if you want to modify the baseboard, means if your requirement does not meet what Toradex carrier boards are providing you, so you can customize it. Because a complex part is already on modules, so customizing a baseboard not require that much of your effort. And also we provide you all the CAE data for all the our carrier boards, so that will be starting point for you. And so that way you don't have to start right from the scratch. You can take off the shelf carrier board from the Toradex, take the CAE data or the LTM based project is there. You can right start from there. You can add your own part of hardware design, and then you are good to go for the production. And then, of course, if your application or your specification permits you the specification match with our own carrier board, you can use our carrier board for the production purpose also. So this is how we are providing you all in one at a one-stop shop. Now, moving forward, we will see the product portfolio from the Toradex module. So at present, Toradex have two family of module. One is Apalis and one is Colibri. So Colibri modules are basically they are small in form factor. They offer you 200 pins on soldering edge connector. They use ARM architecture for their processor. They provide you a scalable module. They provide you all the industrial interfaces to communicate to the outside world. We have module rights start from 500 megahertz, that is Colibri VF50, and then we goes up to 1.4 quad core gigahertz Colibri T30. Then we introduce a IMX 8 series in both families. So with IMX 8 series, we are there in 64-bit architecture. Earlier we were having 32-bit architecture for all the modules. So this is how Colibri modules are placed. So on the other hand, we have a Apalis module. So they feature high speed interface connectivities. They feature supreme graphics. So basically this family of module is more targeted toward extensive multimedia application, and they provide better thermal connectivity. Then they feature the direct breakout features, which will really make your baseboard design very easy. So basically both of the modules serve their own market. So depending upon what is your application, what is your targeted area of market, you can select in between those modules. Of course, both modules are using ARM Cortex processor. So we have a Cortex A5 on VF50. Then we have module with Cortex A7. We have a A9. We have with A15, A35, A53, and A72. So we have all the Cortex series in our module family. Of course, there are some modules which support microcontroller core. So you can offload the real-time activities. You can run FreeRTOS there. You can run bare metal firmware there so that your application processor core is not bottlenecked with the real-time data acquisition or maybe some task you want to do in real time. So that there are also some modules which support this kind of architecture. Both modules, both family of modules are pin-to-pin compatible amongst each other. What that means is you can upscale or you can downscale if your requirement does not fit that particular specification. So for example, if you have used the Colibri IMX7 and now you want to upscale to for better specification or better graphic performance. So if you have already used the Toradex compatible features, means you have used the specification from that list, so you can upscale to IMX6 for better graphic performance, for better memory performance. And if you really want to downgrade also to meet your cost optimization, then if you have already used features from compatible list, so you can downscale also. You don't have to modify your baseboard for every specification you are making a modification. So all in one, we provide complete solution for your embedded computing, be it any market you want to pitch in your product. So we provide all the reliable software and everything. Now moving forward, this slide shows in-house operating system support which Toradex is offering for their modules. On the first row, we have Torizon, we have embedded Linux offering, we have WinC, and then FreeRTOS. Then on the first column, we shows the list of modules with support. So this basically give you a whole picture how modules are supported with which operating system. So based on the operating system supported, you can really decide what technology you want to use, where you want to pitch your module. So to give an example, if your application demands real-time activities, you can select a module where there is a microcontroller core on it. If you are having existing application developed in WinC or you need WinC support, then you can select the module where WinC is already ported on our module. We have WinC 6, we have WinC 7, then we have WC 2013, that is WinC compact edition. So all the modules do support WinC, can run in this kind of operating system. Now, if you have already the Yocto compatible image, or you want to do it by customized image by you on your own, then we do provide embedded Linux for all the modules. And now with our latest offering or newly introduced module, we are coming with Torizon. We will understand more about Torizon in coming slides. So before moving to Torizon, we will first see what exactly currently we are offering for embedded Linux as our operating system. So it really features customized OS using Yocto project. So using Yocto, you can really customize the image which we are providing you. You can add the packages, you can remove the packages, add your configurations, add your application inside the operating system only. There are many layers we are providing. So using that layer, you can start right from there. You don't have to do from the scratch. You can leverage all the tools which Yocto has to offer. So there are many layers across the community which you can utilize. So this is how Yocto is really providing you a customizable image. So you can really make an image which is very small in footprint, or depending upon use cases, you can really add the packages. Then Linux SDK. So one of the output of Yocto is Linux SDK. Using this SDK, you can set the toolchain on your host environment to do the cross compilation of application. So this application, since it is compiling on your host and it is targeted for the ARM architecture, so we say it like a cross compilation. So this provide you all the file system on your host itself, so that when you are building your application, their linking and resolving does not occur. So this is again the output of Yocto project. Then for bootloader, we are using U-boot as a standard. So you can for all our board, we provide U-boot for the bootloader, which we also provide the source code on the GitHub repository, and we provide all the instructions how you can cross compile U-boot at your host. So that is also provided on our developer page. So U-boot basically provide you the command line interface. This command line interface you can access on our debug serial port. So using this command line interface, you can change various parameters, like you can manipulate the device tree. We will understand device tree in coming point. Then you can modify the display resolution. You can modify the boot device you want to boot. So you have option to boot from onboard memory, from NAND memories or the EMMC, which is there onboard with Toradex module. Then you have option to boot from the external memory, like SD card or USB, even SATA on Apalis series. Then you have option to boot from the network. So these kind of configuration you can do right from the command line interface of U-boot. Then all these modern SoC, they feature multiplexed on every pin. So all the pins are having more than one function. We need to, before the system boot, we need to tell the system what pins are used for what purpose. So that is the task of device tree binary. So device tree binary basically tells the module how the device is configured, how particular pin is configured for what functionality. To give you a better example, you can use I2C on different pin, but on that I2C also you can attach different device, like it can be touch controller, it can be ADC or PWM ICs. So based on that, there will be a node inside the device tree file. So using that node, you can really tell what kind of driver you want to use, what pin are used, and what is the interrupt for those pin. So this is really simplifying the process of telling the operating system what are the device attached. You are customizing your baseboard, or if you are making your own carrier board, so you can use our device tree. We have provided our device tree in kernel source code. Using that, you can start from there itself and do your changes and make a device tree available for you. to make the effect on the running module, you need to compile the device tree and then update the module with the device tree binary. And then on the next reboot, you can see the affected changes on your module. So every time you need to add, you need to remove, or you need to modify some device, you need to compile the device tree binary at your host and then update this module to make the changes affected. Then for application development, we do provide support for Eclipse. So using this Linux SDK, you can configure Eclipse project inside, and from there directly you can deploy to our module. You can use GDB server to debug the application directly from the Eclipse ID. Now, if your application demands GUI framework, where you want to use Qt for your GUI language, Qt Creator you can use for development. You can use the drag and drop feature of Qt Creator to make a simple GUI, and same you can see in real time when you're deploying to our module. There can be more support for IDs, but that depends upon the use cases. So one point like roadmap for BSP. So we are providing all the roadmap of our embedded Linux offering to Horizon and every software we are doing on our public website. So you can really plan your activities. You can really plan your project as per the roadmap we have already shared. We list down all the things like the known issues, the features we are going to add, any things which is not planned, or the time and date when it's going to be fixed. So this really provide you ease of access of all the information. Using that information, you can really plan your project for and meet the promises for your customer. So now next we will understand overview of Torizon. This is our new operating system. Basically it's a Linux based platform, and we made this to simplify your process of developing software or managing your software in a more easy way, so that you don't have to learn the steep learning curve of Yocto. You don't have to dig deep inside the layers and understand all the process, because at the end of the day, you really concern about your application logic and development. So that's why this feature like fast time to market, since you don't need to enter in really deep things of Yocto and customizing the operating system by yourself. So this is how it is solving the fast time to market problem for you. Then we know more and more devices are getting connected to internet, and they are having internet connectivities. They are reachable from the remote location. So the simple updates become a real concern for all the companies, because we see no companies want to recall their device from the field or send their person to the field just for adding some feature, just for updating critical security patches, because this really demands capital, this really demands times, and also it's not offering you a very good experience with your customer. So with Torizon, you have the possibilities to use over the air update capabilities. We will understand a bit in later. This over the air update is still in the development stage, but it will be out soon. Now with the over the air update, since your device is getting connected to internet, then there is a concern for security. So anybody can access the device, and then it can change your root file system, your application, or they can flash their own software. So security has to be met to meet this kind of requirement. So now with Torizon, the security features are really accessible now. So we have transport layer security, we have hashing, cryptographic library, then we have a SHA system. So everything can be accessible in a more easy way now. We do provide, and now we provide with Torizon real-time patch for the kernel. So there is a different version for it. You can directly download from our server, install on our Toradex module. So now you don't have to do by yourself. You can directly download from our server and use it. Now, another important issue is like how stable is the software, or how stable is the offering we are doing. So with Torizon, all our images are continuously tested with CI server. So every time we are pushing any changes, or we are pushing doing any features, so that has been that is tested by the server continuously, and upon successful build only we are providing you that image. And suppose if there is something broke down, so we now know where that problem occurs, and we can fix in quick time or zippy time, so that you don't have to suffer that easily, suffer not that much. Now, some of the feature which Torizon is offering you. So Torizon is based on a Linux micro platform. So this is a minimum base system which is offering a low memory footprint. So upon that, we are using Docker runtime. So using this Docker runtime, you can run any of the containerized based application or images. So this leverage you that you can use any of the Linux distribution or the packaging system or the libraries which is there to offer for that architecture. So this way you are really free to run multiple distros on the same machine, because that that container is really looking for the Docker runtime to run all these activities and the process. Then we are offering you OT update. So for OT update, we are really making use of OS tree and the opt-in. At the moment, OTA service is in development stage. So, and the features of the OTA are, they are atomical. So they are providing you the rollback when anything happens, when you are doing an update to your device, maybe power failure or the network failure. So using this, you can roll back to the previous working version. Then we are providing you versioning method. So you really don't have to push all the file system. You can only push the difference or the diff of the root file system, which really saves you the network traffic. Then we have device tree overlay. So earlier we have seen that device tree, you need to compile at your host and then deploy it to the machine to take the effect. But now at runtime, you can use device tree overlay. You can just push the change what you want at the runtime, and upon reboot, it can be seen on your device. So you don't have to go the tedious cycle of cross compiling, updating the module, and then seeing the update for your change in the device. So these are the things will help you in your application development, in deployment of your application to the market and to the device. So before we move forward for our application development, first we need to understand what are containers. So because on Torizon, we will be using containers rigorously for our application and the software packaging. So in physical world, containers are simply a steel metal box that are used to ship goods across the countries. So for outside people, all containers look same to the world, but what differentiate them is what are the goods inside them, right? So in software also, all the containers are same to the runtime. They provide you light virtualization. They provide you separated file system inside them. They provide you a way to package your software. They provide you all the dependency inside it so that it can run in his own independent environment. So for developer, what that means is they can simply run the instance of any of the means image, we will say, any of the image, so that they can run the container inside them and all the application is there. So to make a understanding of this container a better, we can correlate it to some of the C++ object model. So container, basically container are running instance of image, and image we can consider similar to the classes. So in classes, we implement our functionality. Same way image provides functionalities, what are the things container is going to run in the image form. Then image, there is layers. So layers are similar to inheritance. So each layer inherit some of the property from the base layer. So these all layers, when they combine and they form the image, and from that image, the container is container can be run. So container is basically at the end of the day is running instance of any image which you have provided to the Docker runtime. So similarly, now we understand that layer are taking the properties from the base layer. Now we know these layer are sharing from bottom to up. So we can really say that we are optimizing the space. So if we are using the base image and then we are providing some functionality to the second layer and to the third layer, so this way we are really optimizing the memory use. So if we want to run 10 different containers, or if you want to run more number of containers using the same base layer, we are really optimizing the memory or the disk usage so that it should not be getting wasted on our embedded platform. Now, another advantage of using the containers are you can package all in one container and you can ship. So when you are developing, you can develop everything, you can test on your system or your environment. So it will run the same way on your target device. So now you are sure that whatever you have tested at your development environment or whatever you have tested at your host, so that same will be going to run on the target in the same way without knowing the configuration or without knowing the underlying hardware. Now containers, they get a unique ID whenever you are running it. So using that unique ID, you can identify the running container, you can attach them, means you can go to the interactive way, or you can run in the background, you can stop them just like a process, you can kill them just like a process. So it's container is basically like a process, but offering you more functionalities. Then containers offer you multiple channels. So using the multiple channels, you can talk to your host system. You can talk to other containers running on the same system. So this is really useful when you are doing your development and you want to make your application communicate within each other. So now we know what are our containers. So now it's time for a short poll before we move forward. So we will give you 10 seconds to register your input and then we will continue. Okay. So we got your input. Thanks for your input. So now we understand what are containers. Now we can see how to in Torizon we are doing the application development. So here is a small block diagram which shows you how things are placed in the, when you are running Torizon on the module. So there are two containers. Like it's just an example. One container is used for rendering your UI. One container is used for serving some static or demo, and one container is running some tool which is used for your diagnostic purpose or registering or logging purpose. So they all are sharing the base image. So here with Torizon, we are offering Debian container as a base image. So you can really start your development right from there. You can leverage the Debian package manager. You can install packages from the feeds. You can really test things very quickly, and then you are ready for your proof of concept. You don't have to do everything from the scratch to test any interface. So you can really leverage the community market for developing your application. Now, for IE, we provide this Visual Studio plugin that you can use in Visual Studio and Windows host. So from this time now, you can also use Windows host to program a Linux device that is running Torizon. So it's a nice feature for those developer who really loves Visual Studio as IDE for development. Plus Visual Studio provide you a lot of intelligence and plugins. So that really makes your development an ease. Similarly, if you have already an application which is developed for Windows and that is using .NET Core and Torizon, we have .NET Core container. So you can really port your application on this target device and it will run the same way as it's running on your Windows host. Similarly for Linux, we are offering a template for VS Code. So using this template, you can do the development inside VS Code for this container image. You can develop a image out of from there. You can deploy it to the target and you can see the changes right from your VS Code editor. So this is out of the box what you are getting with Torizon, which is really making application development easy. For example, we can give an example like if you want to use Python. So you can download any of the container image for Torizon or base image using the from command in a Docker file. Then you can install the package for Torizon. Now you have a container which can run a Python interpreter. So now you can deploy your Python script and it will run on the Torizon. Now some overview about Docker. We will see Torizon comes with a Docker runtime by default. There is an image version which Torizon with Docker runtime. So you can download it directly from our server using Toradex Easy Installer, or you can do offline deployment also when it's going to be stable. Basically, there are two things to notice. One is like Docker engine and one is Docker client. So basically Docker engine process all the requests which Docker commands you are going to initiate. So be it running your image or be it listing down all the images which is on your system. So it takes really process all those commands and provide you the output of that. Then we have Docker Hub. We can understand Docker Hub. It's a central location where you can put all the images you have generated, or you can download the images which is there to offer. It has both community and enterprise version. So for better understanding, we can correlate this to like the Android marketplace. So in Android marketplace, you can download the software and install to your phones. But similarly, from Docker Hub, you can download the images, but you are getting more functionalities. You can add modification, you can add configuration to that images, or you can really base your development based on that images and do application out of it. here are some locations like hub.docker.com, and for Torizon you can really go to this location and you can see all the images we have listed down there with description also. So in short, Docker daemon is responsible for talking to Docker Hub also. So this is how you are getting on the Torizon with Docker runtime. Some more commands. Before we proceed, we need to understand what are the commands we will be using. So Docker pull, this command is used to fetch any of the image that is there on the Docker Hub. So basically when you issue this command, it will go to the Docker Hub registry. It will search for that particular image name, which you will pass to this command. And then if it finds it, it will fetch and it to your local system. Docker run. So this command will use to run the image which you just pulled from the Docker Hub. There are various parameters to this command. You can run in detached mode, and so it will be running in the background. You can restart it at a particular interval of time, or when your system boots, you can run in an interactive way, and so it can provide you the shell where you can put your interact with the Docker container running. So there are a number of parameters available. We can check it later on the Docker reference manual or from the Toradex website also. Then Docker push command, it used to push all the images to central hub registry. So now you have developed an image, you have made some changes to your image, or you generated it using a Docker build command. Now you need to push it to central location. Now when you issue this command, it will take the images from your local system, and then it will put to a central location. From there, all the device can pull the image and run it on their own system. We have Docker file. So a Docker file basically provides all the recipes, or we will say the steps which are used when you are using Docker build command. So Docker build command really reads the Docker file, all the instructions inside the Docker file to generate your image. So that image you can either deploy to your target locally, or you can push to Docker Hub registry for getting it utilized. Then if you are doing offline deployment, you don't want to go every time to Docker Hub to pull or push the image generated, you can use Docker save and Docker load command. So Docker save command really, whatever image you have built, it will be producing an output in the local file system itself, so that using Docker load, you can load that image. So suppose you have generated an image using Docker save command, you need to transfer it to Toradex module, and then using Docker load command, you can run that container out of that image. So these are some basic. Of course, there will be more about commands which we can refer back to in detail in Docker reference manual. Now it's time to run our first Hello World application. So basically it's a very small and simplest image that is available on Docker Hub. We are directly fetching that image from the Docker Hub using a Docker run command. Docker run command, when we issue this command, it will first find the image locally, whether it is there on the target device or not. Upon failing, it will then search for the Docker Hub registry, and upon finding, it will pull all the layers which is required to run this particular application. So at this point, this is a single process, which will echo the message which is already there. And same way, if you want to try some other containers, you can search the Docker Hub registry, you can pull the image, you can run it, and you can see the documentation about it, what are the things they can do and provide you possibilities. So this is our first container which we just ran. It's really simple using this Docker run command. Now moving forward, we will see how we can build one by ourselves. So to build, we are going method of using a Docker file. So in Docker file, we will list down all the steps, which all the script we need for compiling an application. And then we will see how it's running using the cmd command. So on right side, we can see there is a Docker file. It's a sample Docker file, which you can use to compile an application. So from the top to, we can say we are targeting from. So it is basically downloading the Debian base image file from the Docker registry. And then on that, we are installing some of the dependency which we need for compiling our application. Then we are copying the local directory, helloworld.c. So from the local directory, we are copying it to a location on our container. And then we are making it a work directory. From there, using run, we can run any of the command. So we are running GCC, that's a compiler. So using this, we are compiling Hello World and providing you output of hello underscore world. Now cmd is the command which tells any of the image to what to execute when they run using Docker run command. So if you are writing multiple CMD, it will obviously override. So the last CMD will be executed. So here is the step. So first create any directory on your host, then create a Docker file. You put the content of the Docker file in there. Then you need to install Docker at your host system. So we need to remember this. You need to install Docker at your host system. And when you are compiling from the Docker file, then you need to run that on your target system. Of course, we can run ARM. We can simulate ARM architecture on our host also. So there are packages already available. But for today's session, we will keep it simple. So after installing Docker, you need to login it or you need to create an account. Then after that, you need to build. So this is a build command. Username, you need to provide your own. And then there is a dot. So using if this is not by mistake. So if you don't issue this dot, there will be a build time error. And when you pass this dot, then it will search for the Docker file in the same directory. And using this Docker build command, it will output an image for you. Now using Docker push, you can push the generated image to the Docker Central Hub registry. And same way using Docker pull, you can fetch the image. Now this Docker D has to be in small. And on your now you need to go to your target, and the target you can use Docker run and the image name which you generated, and then it will output hello world to your target system. So this is how you are making a simple hello world container and running on your target. Here are a few containers from Toradex which you can download, which you can test, and then you can develop customize it according to you, your use case. So there is a 32-bit version, there is a 64-bit version. So one is like base, which is really minimum. And there you need to add packages as per your requirement. Then we have Debian Western. It's a graphics server. So people who are targeting GUI application or a desktop, they need desktop. So they can make a container out of this server. And then they can make another container, which will be a client library. So that container will be giving all the desktop, sorry, all the UI which is needed to run on the Western server. Similarly, we have a Qt container image. So now you don't need to compile it by yourself. You can use this container as a base for your container, and then you can develop your application of utilizing the Qt framework. Of course, this is using Wayland as a client, so you need to run Wayland Western container also for running any of the graphic application. Then we have from our partner companies. So Codices is there. Then there is a more demo like object detector. Of course, there will be more. We will be coming in future. Now, Toradex Easy Installer. So this is a software from Toradex, which is used for flashing our module. You can really install operating system from our partner companies. You can install operating system directly from Toradex. There are various operating system for, you can see the operating system list for that particular module. For example, if you are running on IMX6, you can see WinSE, you can see embedded Linux. Then in the feeds, you can enable the beta version, the alpha version, where you can see images right from our CI server. You can install Torizon from there. Then you can do offline deployment. There is a means you need to make a USB mass storage where you can put a Toradex Easy Installer compatible image, and then you can do this offline deployment. You can use Toradex Easy Installer for mass production programming. All our module who are supporting Toradex Easy Installer will come by default pre-installed with this software. So you just plug in your mass production image, and then it will automatically install with just a modification of one variable inside the configuration file. So these are the possibilities you can use with Toradex Easy Installer. It's really simplify your production flashing or your development flashing. So it's a very easy to use software. These are some of the important links which you can go to find more information. You can always go to our Getting Started Guide. It's a really easy step-by-step guide where you need to select what SOM you are working, what carrier board is there. Then you have option for selecting operating system. Of course, for those module who only support one operating system, the option will not there. But for the module which support Horizon also, which support then embedded Linux also. So there will be option of selecting embedded Linux or Horizon for the operating system. Then we have a technical article on our developer website. For Torizon related, you can check the link. Then we have a GitHub repository where you can find all the source code. So if you really want to understand how things are working, you can download the source code and read from there and understand from there. We have roadmap, as we already explained, all the features, all the issue list, and all the known issues we are mentioning there. So you can really look, go through the list, and then define your timeline for your client or your customer. Thank you for your interest. So with this, we are going to take question and answer for you. So there are few questions we have, like, where can we get the carrier board CAE data? So it's on our developer.toradex.com knowledge base website. So there is a section of hardware. So there you can see all the CAE data. It's a LTM based project file. So you can get the schematic, you can get the routed file, everything from there you can download. Our next question, does Toradex module support 24/7 application? If yes, how such application can be supported by Toradex? So yes, all our module you can run 24/7. So we have module with thermal management, like on Apache series, we provide a proper thermal management. So the then we have module in IT range so that they can run in really wide temperature range. So these modules are really designed for these kind of activities only. We have module already deployed in many of the industries, and they are running very successfully. So yes, you can use these module for 24/7. How can I flash more than 50 modules for production? So this is really what you need to design at your place. We provide this Toradex installer for production programming. So if you want to flash 50 modules at once, you need to make a setup like that, so that every time you are plugging this USB drive that is meant for production programming, so those system can do automatic install. So which segment and the application we can promote this part? I think you are talking about Torizon. So basically all our modules are generic, means they are providing you just embedded computing power. So it's up to you where you can pitch your module. Of course, depending upon industry you are working on, or depending upon the area where you want to, there may be some addition you want to do, there may be some designing you want to do, but really these are very general, generic embedded computer on modules. Can you customize the SOM for the customers? It's really depend on the use cases, but of course you can send us query, we can discuss on this part. So and what is the timeline and lead time for the module? So for this I will request Vishwas to provide the answer.
Thanks Ritesh. Yeah, so as far as lead time is concerned, particularly for pilot or proto quantities, we are maintaining the stock locally in India, and these will be off the shelf available. But certainly when it comes to volume production, we would be needing orders and forecasts from our customers. So I think working together, we can manage that. And second thing I want to highlight is particularly as you have seen in a SOM, it consists of like processor, flash, RAM, and many of the other peripheral components. So when you are buying these modules from Toradex, you don't have to worry about the lead times for those 10 or 20 critical parts. That lead time is managed by Toradex on the backside. So I think that is one of the advantage of using SOM rather than designing a particular solution from component level. Because in some cases we have seen this saves a design cycle time of about 8 months. And that is a unique value proposition offered by Toradex.
Thank you, Shaz. So and we have few more questions, like what feature can you provide for the secure team? So we are working on a secure boot, but it's still in development. So as soon as we have something concrete, we will put on our website of our knowledge base. Then we have question like, can I load Torizon in one CPU and embedded Linux in another CPU? So Torizon is basically, this is an embedded Linux. So what you can do, you have application providing running this container directly, and on top of that you can have your host system, but we don't see this scenario to be useful for production. is this soft real time or hard real time? So Linux is always soft real time. So if you really need hard real time, you can use asymmetrical architecture processors like IMX7 offering you this M4 part. Then IMX8 series, they are also offering you this M4 part. Then there is DSP already in IMX8. So these are modules which can serve real time response for you. So if needed, can Toradex write drivers for you? This really depends upon your use case, what you really need from us. So generally we do support on our best effort basis. We try to implement everything for interface which we are already offering to you. But if you have any custom requirement, we can talk on it, we can discuss on it, and if it is really permit, we can do on support our basis. Is local support is available? Yes, we are locally available in India. We have three offices. So one is in Bangalore, and one in Pune, and we one in North. So if you really need local presence, we are there. You can always call us. We can provide you support to your office and over call also. How can I run Ubuntu with Torizon? So since Torizon, everything we are depending on container. So there are container images for Ubuntu. You can directly download from the Docker Hub registry. And based on that, you can add your packages or your software and package it and run on Torizon. Do you support LabVIEW? At the moment, we do not have a direct support from Toradex, but there were version for running on WinC, which you can really talk to LabVIEW guys, or you can drop an email. We can provide you best information for that also. Then we have a question like, for OTA, can we use our server or need to use Toradex specific? So there are both options. For if you want to host your own server, you can use OTA Community Edition. But at the same time, you need to implement many of the features by yourself. And then since we are already working on OTA, we will see how we can provide all the service to our customers. So we have one question, how can Toradex support customers to customize the carrier board? We promote our eco partner companies to do customized carrier board for you. But it's a really means depend upon the requirement. If it is one or two interface, you can do on add-on board, and you can use our existing carrier board for your design layout. But your design needs some complex part, so of course we can connect you to our ecosystem partner companies. They will help you in your design and development. So thank you all for joining this webinar. I hope this is useful for you, and you will get the recorded session in coming weeks. Thank you all. Have a nice day.